Hello and welcome to this month's episode of Looking Back, Looking Forward. And this is the final episode for the year. And it has been a pretty incredible year. I don't think any of us could have imagined in any way back in January when we started this series just how bad this year would turn out to be. And I think if we look back over our series of episodes, we followed the crisis from the very beginning, looking at the role that digital finance has played in that crisis, and more recently, looking at some of the implications of the crisis for digital finance going forward. And I think if we look at COVID-19, what can we say? We can say that from the standpoint of digital finance, it has absolutely driven digitization. It has absolutely driven digital finance as people have been locked down and have had no choice but to live via e-commerce, electronic payments, and mobile telephones. Now, if we think about some of the implications we've seen that that digitization has played out in the context of, first, money and payment, in particular, discussions around building better systems of money and payment, things like central bank digital currencies. We've seen how it's played out in RegTech, in regulatory technologies, as not only financial institutions, financial employees, but also financial supervisors and central bankers have had to work from home and have had to engage with one another and compliance and supervisory processes at a distance. We've seen the impact that it's had on non-face-to-face transactions, in particular, customer onboarding in the context of anti-money laundering, and the drive that this is having in the context of sovereign digital identity systems. And the final aspect that we haven't quite discussed yet is the impact that all of this digitization is having from the standpoint of data and concentration. And in our last video, I talked about how we had written a few years ago about the idea of the evolution of FinTech, of FinTech 1.0, of FinTech 2.0, of FinTech 3.0, and how we mark 2020 as the beginning of FinTech 4.0. And what is FinTech 4.0 all about? It's all about digital finance platforms. And the fact that in financial services, finance is an industry that benefits from economies of scope and scale. It's an industry where there is a natural tendency towards concentration and fewer numbers. And at the same time, data and technology is an industry that benefits from economies of scope and scale. We call it network effects. What does that mean? It means the more users, the more data you can get on a platform and an ecosystem, the greater your advantage. And what we are seeing is in both the coming together of finance and technology, that today finance and data with the digitization of finance are the same thing. And what we are seeing are the emergence of ever larger digital finance platforms. And I think the first week of November of 2020 showed this more clearly than anything before. And that was the week that Ant Financial was scheduled to have the world's largest IPO. It was scheduled to raise $37 billion across the Hong Kong and Shanghai stock exchanges. And one day before that IPO was scheduled to start, Chinese regulators stepped in and halted it. Why? Because from the standpoint of their perspective looking at Ant Financial, Ant had become so big that it had become too big to fail. And what does that mean? From the lessons that we learned from the 2008 crisis, it means that we need to step in to take actions to make sure that they manage their risks in an appropriate way. And so what do we see? We see Chinese financial regulators stepping in to put in place new regulations on Ant Financial to curb some of the business and to curb some of the dominance that it has not only in payments and data and finance, but across the financial sector generally. And this is exactly a challenge that we're seeing from across the world. And in a new paper, we examine these issues around digital finance platforms. We highlight the traditional financial approach, this idea of looking at regulation to prevent too big to fail. We look at competition and antitrust approaches, the sorts of approaches that are being taken with the US, with Google and new antitrust actions, and new approaches focusing on data, first open banking in the EU, and now a new strategy in Europe called the Digital Finance Strategy, which is focusing on open data, open finance, as a way to control and reduce the impact of these large platforms. And that's an issue that we're going to start with next time. But for now, I'd like to wish you all a better 2021 and thank you all for your attention in 2020.